So relaxed, in fact, that she decides to take over.
You need to get everyone to come in around one person. Everyone,
we haven't got time.
We haven't got time.
Right, go take
it. Hiya!
And it looks like Alex is not the only one to have overindulged.
Come on your knees there, Dan.
One of the candy bar's better known patrons is 24-year-old ex-Big Brother housemate, Shabby Catchatorian. She's at home in North London getting ready to meet up with her friend Red.
She's just come back from India, where she's been for a couple of months, and we actually really missed each other, and kind of more than you would just miss your friend.
I basically have my fingers in all the pies. I'm a pie fingerer.
Free spirit Shabby splits her life between music, clothes designing and DJing.
Anything that I come up with that I want to do, I'll just do it because I figure, why not? If it fails, it fails, but I want to try everything.
And that even included appearing on Big Brother, where she made a big impact.
I have got a lot of female attention since, just because I went on Big Brother, which is not really a good reason to fuck somebody, is it? It's Big Brother.
Now Shabby's looking to settle down, and she thinks the time is right for her and Red to move from friendship to relationship.
I do think that tonight is a big risk for mine and Red's friendship. But there are just some things that feel worth it. Yeah, we can continue as mates, but I don't want to just be friends with her. I want the whole shebang. And if she, you know, doesn't feel the same and, you know, does, you know, wants a little flirty date but doesn't want anything else, then I'm gonna look like a right twat.
And for their risky first date, Shabby's chosen to take Red to a sushi restaurant in central London.
Here's to
our Willis.
Fish all night, raw fish, all night long. Wow, I remember the first night I met you, we were sitting on the sofa and there was like everyone partying and this kind of thing, and we talked for so long.
Yeah, yeah, I remember that.
And I actually find most people really, really boring to talk to.
I thought you were so boring to talk. I was like,
some nice ladies. Hi! Delicious. Oh, I think that vodka's got me, babe.
What do you think?
And for a first night date, things seem to be progressing well.
I'm just a bit drunk and a bit happy and giddy. I haven't felt this in a while, so this is nice. She's a good one.
She got me drunk, basically, so, yeah, now I'm, like, flying. No, I had fun. I really did. I have fun. I love sushi. I love Shabby. She makes me laugh. I think she's fit.
We need to go back to my house soon. Not all of us, obviously. Just me and her.
It's the morning after a big night out for Danny and long-term girlfriend, Lucy.
Why do you look like a chav?
What?
You look like a posh chav.
What?
I'm going dancing later.
Like that?
What do you mean?
And having managed to lose her keys, Danny's had to get Lucy to break the door down.
I said, you know, stuff it, I'll just kick the door in. And so I did, and luckily I only took the lock off. I didn't knock the whole door off the hinge. But I have a really bully hand.
The couple met at university in Manchester, and Lucy was Danny's first girlfriend. They've been in a committed relationship for 3 years, but are trying something new since moving to London.
When we made the decision to go into the open relationship, we did it because we're real. Like, you know, we'd been at uni, we were together very much, you know, like this, as a couple. And then when you move to London, like, we're young, you know, you can be young and in love, but you shouldn't like, marry yourself away.
Despite having initiated the open relationship, Lucy's finding the reality difficult to deal with.
Well, she kissed one of my friends overnight, and that really pissed me off. So we spoke about that yesterday, and I think that's what made me more upset yesterday, because, like, I'm trying to teach her about the lesbian code, and now, as incestuous as lesbians are portrayed to be, we're all still loyal to each other as friends.
Get your tits out. Oh, no, wait, you ain't got any.
I do.
You keep telling yourself that.
I do.
36B.
After the drunken photo shoot, Gary and Sandra have got their hands on the pictures for their new face of the candy bar.
For the initial advert, we have to narrow down the number of people we're going to use in it for starters. It's going to be 2 or 3, not 5 or 6. This is obviously his best, because he's cut them down. I mean, I think the first advert that we're going to put out for candy bar has to set an idea of what we're trying to do with the candy bar, who we're targeting with it. We want to try and make it a bit more sexy than it was, bring it up to date, make it about here and now girls. Girls with attitude, girls with lesbian attitude.
He may know plenty about the male gay scene, but when it comes to lesbians, Gary's less sure of himself.
Can I be old-fashioned and perhaps misogynistic and ask, is she very lesbian?
I think she's got part boyish, part femme, and then part alternative. So she kind of has kind of dipped into all the kind of lesbian genres, if you can say that.
Right. That to me is a slightly scary picture.
It's a little bit harder than the other images that there are.
That's going to scare a straight man.
Well, we're not wanting to get straight men in the bar, really.
No, I agree. This is the kind of image of a woman that a gay man would find attractive, because it's Hollywood style, blonde, buxom, cartoon character, feminine woman. I'm absolutely shocked that it happens to be one of our staff who I wouldn't consider to be feminine in the least. Little did they know she was lying flat on the ground 20 minutes after the photo shoot. My gut feeling is to remove 1, 2, 3, 4, leaving us these three in the middle.
I agree.
After such a successful first date, Shabby and Red are getting ready for a night out in trendy Camden in North London for their second.
So I think tonight could be fairly interesting.
I'm drunk.
So I have to take this out.
Yeah.
And despite Shabby's checkered relationship history, all seems to be going well.
I'm really drunk.
Yeah, I know you're really drunk. This is the problem, like, this is a problem in that we have very different ways of drinking. Like, to me, I can have a few glasses of wine before I go out, and that's kind of the start of things, you know? For you, you literally open the wine and go...
And then I'm
then you're fucking wrecked.
Yeah, we are kind of the opposites.
And you can't stay up as long as I do.
No.
Should be on the guest list, Shabby Kachadurian.
Cool.
Yeah, cool.
Just go straight food.
Oh, thank you very much.
Evening notice.
Cheers, mate.
Thank you, mate.
But once they are in the club, ex-Big Brother star Shabby is soon in demand with her fans. As the night progresses, drink gets the better of them and tempers get frayed. These girls fall like dominoes.
This early on, I didn't want this many dramas with a girl. I like Red a lot, but... Okay, we're supposed to be going through the honeymoon period right now, and if this is what the fucking honeymoon period is like, I dread to think what the actual relationship is going to be like.
Coming up...
Home sweet home, here it is.
Returning home is not all it's cut out to be.
How can I pretend to be excited about this?
And a 3-year relationship is coming to an end.
I think we would be happier if we were just friends.
so we're at you know, at the exit point for when you come out, and we're all standing there. No, but and yes, but sort of. I'm really looking forward to seeing you.
Jo Weber, the ex-editor of one of the leading lesbian magazines, G3, is back from her travels. And rolling out the red carpet is her loving parents.
Hi, Jo. How are you?
It's lovely. This is so crazy, isn't it?
Yeah.
What drives me? Spontaneity, the randomness of life, just going with the universe.
Worried her life was becoming spiritually bereft, 29-year-old Jo left her media career behind for a five-month journey of self-discovery.
Going into this hut with his Mayan family and hanging out with their pet, which was a spider monkey, was just brilliant. Some woman ran up to me, you know, in this sort of fit of anguish, going, oh my God, you have an incredible aura. Anyway, I gave her $8 and we moved on. I just sort of squatted down and a wild boar did come and sort of sniff me in a rather intrusive way, but I just sort of got over that.
And her bizarre experiences won't be ending there. With no money or job, she's having to move back in with mum and dad.
It is certainly a little unusual being back with my parents. So I kind of view it as short-term pain for long-term gain. My mum is a very special, unique woman. She's definitely got her own views and opinions, and I love to listen to them at length.
I go away for 5 months, Mum. What's happened?
This is new social housing stuff.
Lovely, very tasteful. I love North West London, I really do.
After living in fashionable Shoreditch before her travels, the suburbs of North West London just isn't quite the same for Jo.
Home sweet home, here it is. God, how can I pretend to be excited about this? I just want to be back in Shoreditch.
Until Jo told me she was a lesbian, I'd never met anybody who'd actually said that they were a lesbian. I mean, I suppose, you know, maybe when I was younger, I thought some, you know, the unmarried young ladies who were particularly unattractive or something like that might have been lesbians, but I didn't really know anything about it. I had no idea, you know, goose stockings maybe, I don't know. You know, the ones who went to university years ago and didn't get married. I don't know, maybe, but that was about it.
Coming back to Stanmore, to Northwest London, is kind of like taking a step back, but I just need to be really strong, really positive, and build my life here again in London, because this is my reality for the foreseeable. Woohoo!
Lovely, Jo, to have you home. Absolutely. Toast to Jo.
Thanks, cheers. Parents. Thanks
really
for supporting me.
Really happy to have you home.
Cheers.
Love
cheers.
To have you home.
Cheers.
Lovely. Salute, slancha, chin chin.
L'chaim.
L'chaim. just in French.
Salut in Spanish, of course, and cheers in America.
Cheers.
I can't believe that all my cuddly toys have been laid out. This guy here, Snowy, is my oldest teddy. He's a little worse for wear, but yeah, he kept me warm on many lonely nights. No, that's horrific.
You're right. Meanwhile, at the candy bar, Gary is still planning on opening in just a few days, but he's spotted more signs of his least favourite colour.
Sophie, I mean, the other thing we need to get rid of is the pink, even from the light. Is that actually just something over the light?
It's going to be the same what is inside.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah.
Okay, I want that white light. The candy bar sign will have to change.
What about red?
What?
What about red?
No, I want white.
Downstairs, Danny Orsi has arrived to work on her pole dancing routine.
While they're closing it, it's a good time to practice.
And pretty soon, it's all go in the lower bar, as Gary's Polish builders need to attend to some urgent structural work.
We do flick. Here.
Urgent work. Back in Northwest London, Jo's homecoming isn't getting any easier.
Shall we have
Corfu, lovely.
Corfu coasters. You wanted some coasters.
We've got coasters.
Well, we've got Corfu coasters. What's wrong with that?
And along with coasters, Mum clearly thinks her little girl needs feeding up.
I'll just serve Jo's dinner. Right?
All that gourmet food in Paris and now this lovely.
Well, you love salmon, don't you?
I do love salmon, yes.
And you like greens, and they won't cook for very long.
I remember when I kissed my first girl, it was at Camden Palais, and I was 17, and that was a real game changer for me, because